Hey students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing great and congratulations for making it up to a higher class. Welcome and let us begin with our new session and a fresh class and get back to our studies with a fresh mind. You must have received a worksheet based on figures of speech, and here I am going to explain you about the similar figures of speech so that you get a better understanding regarding the same. So let us begin with, first of all, you must have read the various names by which the poetic devices can be called, that is figures of speech, literary devices or poetic devices or rhetorical devices. Let us begin with the first poetic device that you must have read, that is rhyme. Rhyme itself says, we have learnt in a poem about the rhyming scheme, how the poem sounds. So when we say, for example, twinkle twinkle little star, how I wonder what you are. So in these two lines, the two rhyming words are star and are. So when these two words create a rhyme, they are known to be having the poetic device called rhyme. Similarly, like Isabel, Isabel met an enormous bear. Isabel, Isabel did not care. So bear and care both have a rhyme and they are called the having poetic device as rhyme. Let us begin to the second poetic device. Now, second poetic device is alliteration. Alliteration is a poetic device wherein a sound of an alphabet is repeated in a sentence or in a line. For example, Betty bought a bitter butter. Betty got a bitter butter. If you see, the sound B or a sound of B is being repeated when I see this, say this sentence. Betty bought bitter butter. So this line is told to have the poetic device of alliteration. Another example. She sells a seashell on the seashore. Here the sound of S is being repeated. Hereby it has the poetic device called alliteration. Let's move on to the third poetic device. The third poetic device is repetition. The word itself says repetition means repeat. So when an entire word is being repeated in a line, it is known to have the poetic device repetition. For example, twinkle, twinkle, little, star. So here you see the word twinkle is being repeated. So if a word is repeated more than one time, that line is called to have the poetic device repetition. Okay. Now, the fourth poetic device. The fourth poetic device that you must have read about is metaphor. This is a word which you have heard in the previous class also. Metaphor is a word wherein a comparison takes place. For a comparison, you require two things. The one, what is being compared, and the another to which it is being compared. So when a comparison takes place without the word as or like, it is called metaphor. For example, he is the Einstein of the class. So he is directly being compared to the word Einstein without word as and like. So this line is said to be an example of metaphor.